Kid Gavilan, wearing the white trunks, is in the ring with a very rugged foe tonight. King of the welterweights, he is fighting Walter Cartier, a contender for the middleweight title. Cartier, at 159 pounds, is 10 pounds heavier than the flashy Cuban. And flashy is the word for Gavilan tonight. For his thousands of fans in Madison Square Garden, he is showing his virtuosity as a puncher, the variety of blows that have made him a favorite of the boxing public. The first two rounds have gone to Cartier. Gavilan starts to put on the pressure. It's Gavilan's round at the bell. Last round, and Cartier's on the verge of winning the fight on points. For the past six rounds, Gavilan has failed to press the attack. And at this point, the crowd knows the only way their favorite can win is by a knockout. And the Kid knows this, too. Gavilan picking up the pace. Look at him set himself and aim. A blistering overhand right has Cartier groggy, and his head is an open target. A slamming right by Gavilan, and Cartier goes down. And that's it. Ruby Goldstein signals the fight is over. It's a tremendous ring triumph for Gavilan, who came from the edge of certain defeat to a smashing KO victory over Walter Cartier. Willie Pep in the dark trunks and Lulu Perez in white. Pep, 31 years old, and an ex-featherweight champion, is on the comeback trail. This is Willie's 190th fight in his long career, and he's been beaten only six times. He's as crafty as they come. A solid right to the head, and Pep is down. Willie up at the count of eight. Perez boring in. Pep covering up, trying to stay in there. Again, those jabs and hooks, and Willie Pep is holding him off, but Lulu is going to send him down again. Watch that right hand. There it is. This time, Willie takes a count of nine from referee Al Burrow. Willie's on his feet, but not for long. Perez is after him like a buzzsaw. There he goes, and this time, the camera brings you the knockdown in slow motion. That's all for Willie Pep. Under New York State Boxing Commission rules, three knockdowns in a single round means it's over. The former featherweight champion's comeback is shattered. Ended in 1 minute, 53 seconds of the dramatic second round. In the opposite corner, the winner, the jubilant Lulu Perez. That's Tony DeMarco in the black trunks and Carmen Basilio in the white. Tony is making his first defense of his welterweight title since he won it from Johnny Saxton just 2 months ago. Carmen, a real rugged rock'em sock'em type fighter, has not been defeated in his last 11 fights. This is the 10th round, and it's been a seesaw battle all the way. Neither fighter has given an inch, and both of them have thrown everything they've got at each other. That right hand hurts DeMarco, and he's in trouble. The champion goes down. Referee Harry Kessler shouts the count into his ears. He's up, but staggering. Five clean shots by Basilio, and DeMarco is down again, falling heavily on the apron of the ring. see a fight like this one between Tony DeMarco and Carmen Basilio. At this point, the champion in the black trunks is just managing to hang on. The challenger, Basilio, is ripping him with everything he has, and this time, Tony won't last the round. Stops the fight, and Carmen Basilio becomes the welterweight champion of the world. World champion Bobo Olsen wearing black trunks and Sugar Ray Robinson, the challenger, wearing white. It's the second round of this middleweight championship fight in Chicago Stadium. For Olsen, this is the third time he's faced Sugar Ray. On both previous occasions, Robinson beat him. A lightning barrage of punches, and Olsen hits the deck. Referee Sikora picks up the count. It's all over. For the third time, Robinson is the middleweight champion of the world. Winner by a knockout in the second round, Sugar Ray is once more the king of his division. A record coast crowd of 20,000 fans jam-packed Wrigley Field in Los Angeles to see the return bout for the middleweight championship of the world between Sugar Ray Robinson and Bobo Olsen. It's the fourth round, and at this point, the champion leads Olsen on all of the officials' cards. Referee Mushy Callahan breaks the two fighters. Robinson has the outstanding record of 137 wins against only four losses, 89 of those wins by KOs. Olsen also can put him away, as proven by his 30 knockouts and his 65 victories. Now look out for trouble. A right and a crushing left, and Olsen is flat on his back. Bobo rolls over but can't get up. 8, 9, 10. At 2 minutes and 51 seconds of the fourth round, Sugar Ray Robinson wins by a knockout and once again proves that he is one of the greatest champions the boxing game has ever known.